But anyways, back on Zorin. Zorin has interfaces that can run like Windows, Windows 2000, Windows 7. I'm preferential to running an OS 10 kind of interface. But there's a whole host of software that can be downloaded and run in Zorin. Zorin comes pre-installed with Chrome for a browsing system, and Chrome runs really fast. Chrome also allows us to run extensions like, say, Crackle if we want to go through and click on a movie and play a movie. We can do that right in Chrome, and it has no problem. And then for other factors like, say, downloading a torrent, we can click on a torrent, and let's say The Walking Dead, and that's going to take me to the site, and I'm going to start a download like that, and start a download, and then we've got a download going. But where's it going? Where is that download going? If we fire up Miro, which is a podcaster, and we look under the downloads, then we've got The Walking Dead downloading right into H.264, right into our Miro player. And Miro is going to hold all your videos, so you can set up podcasts in here as well, built right into Miro. Miro runs so nice on Linux, and it runs so nice on Zorin. It's just really nice. There's a podcast here that I have unplayed, but we can scroll up to podcasts that have been played. And what they do is they resume at exactly where we left off. So if we click the stop button, we go back, and like say here, and I start back up, and they start right back up where you start off. And that's beautiful if you're really busy and you only have time to watch a certain amount of a podcast, and then you need to go to work or come back and you can watch a movie. But it's really a good controllable media system. I mean, I like Xbox Media Center, I like Boxy, but I want it simple and I want it to work. So I can gather lots of information on movies, audio. Amazon is built in here, so I can order and I can scroll down to the Amazon, and I can order MP3s. Here's Amazon MP3 store, and I can go down and let's just do a little bit of this stuff. It's just have for fun. Here's some tracks or movies I can play and tracks, but there's just tons of free stuff, and free is good. There's Clearbits. Here's an audiobook, A Christmas Story. I was looking through some free audiobooks that I could go through in Clearbits, and if it's an audiobook here, these are all free. Here's Ella, there's a lot of stuff we can go through and listen to. Ooh, the Bible 2.0. Okay, and here's I can click on download. And then if I go into the, this is just all built right in, plug and play, ready to go on my computers. And if I go into the downloads, there'll be two in here, Bible audiobook, and it just nicely holds all the information. Now, while they're downloading, you're not going to be able to play them, but it just stores the videos and music in separate folders, and you can go from there, and you can just literally start collecting, lots and lots of videos. Now, Miro is kind of time, so like podcasts over a certain amount of time, kind of like your old junk email, it gets deleted automatically. So, but it also has manual deletes so that I can like trash it then. But if not, the default for the player, so it doesn't load up on too many podcasts because as we keep downloading, this one's 200 megabytes. That's not too big for an MP4 QuickTime file. But as we go forward, we want to be have the ability to just kind of like delete files, and we can change those options to our means. But overall, we were running an operating system that is more, it's actually allowing us to grab our files, to grab music. If I want to do web authoring, I can do that. I can do a whole lot in this operating system that I would do in Windows. And also, I can get my media. Now, the Software Center is full of tons of software files that you can install. There's also the ability to run programs and install selected Windows programs that you might miss, like Internet Explorer, if you're used to that. There's some other front-end systems like Myth TV, and Myth TV works pretty darn good. It's another front-end player, media system that works. It's fairly clean. It takes a day to learn the interface. And it basically, like Xbox MC, it'll allow you to, basically just a front end for playing music and movies. Not any ability to download anything, not any ability to really stream much, like in Miro. But again, we've got huge selections and just a matter of what we want to use. Now, come pre-installed is LibreOffice, which will save as an Office 2007 file, so I can save docs or do most of my Office activity here and save it in a Word-compatible format if I need to. But either way, I'm going to be able to get my work done. And there's just a lot of software here that's booted that you'd never see in a Windows interface because, Windows is always loaded with pretty much nothing. Even if it's factory default, you have to install your stuff as you go. But this is preloaded with lots and lots of software apps and lots more ones, and most of them cost nothing. And our goal is to, operating system and software. Yeah, software should have a price, but I mean, our fundamentals should have stuff that gets us going for just about nothing. And that's what I really like about running a and Linux is just solid as an operating system. I'm sorry, people, we got you beat. We got Mac even beat. This is going to run more solid than any Macintosh operating system. I'm sorry, and Mac. Guess what? Mac ultimately came from, OS X ultimately came from Steve Jobs' next generation computers. The next generation company that he ran before this, his operating system was designed from Solaris. Solaris was from Sun Microsystems, which was a Linux-based piece of software. So the augmentation of OS X really ultimately comes from a Linux-based kernel. Android, as we know, is all Linux. And people like Android because it's been opened and people can really manufacturers can really dabble in it. But the problem with Android, like with the Kindle Fire, is that I can't put Chrome on it. It's very, very restricted operating system. It's closed to a selection of software that I only can go through the Amazon store with, say, a Kindle Fire. Now, there are open forms of Android. From like say a Nexus One, but that tablet's going to be about $600 to $800, depending on how big the hard drive is in it. And this operating system is $10, 12 bucks, 10 euros. And it just is. These guys have refined it and built a beautiful thing. And they're working on it constantly. And it has Bluetooth integration, so it can run Bluetooth keyboards and Bluetooth headsets and then pretty much anything Bluetooth. And it's kind of up hardware compatible, but I'm going to put these in mini computers and sell them for streaming boxes and productivity boxes. Because when we buy a streaming device, streaming devices stream, and that's all they do. They don't do anything else, for $100 to $200. I want a complete computer system to sell to people that does, pretty much everything. And has lots of software in it for them to do that, that they don't have to pay for. It's all built into it, and runs fast. And those are the objectives. I think that should be an objective for any computer manufacturer is have performance, stability, offer lots of software for free, and then you have, a clientele. Then you have something that you can use with people and they can enjoy. But anyways, that's this video. Well, there'll be many more. That will be uploading to YouTube, but I hope you had a good time, and we'll take you through a lot of the software that's built into Zorin. I'm not going to show you how to build a Zorin box. My objective is to sell Zorin boxes to people, and that's about it for now, but we'll give more information on software that can be used in Zorin. Thank you. Have a good day. Bye-bye.